The next morning, a crowd of people forced their way out of the ticket office next to us to raid MC Bun to get some food to eat. Something got to them during the night. We heard them screaming in fear, and they didn't get back to the room. We covered all the windows with drapes and blankets so that we didn't get hurt if something else happened, like another explosion. I really hope they're okay. Edward was okay. I couldn't believe it. Edward was still there. He was scared, and some of the coaches were badly burned, but he was okay. Edward was low on coal, but he did have enough water left to make it to Tidmouth. If engines would be hiding anywhere on the island, it's there. We were shocked to see James pull up to the station with empty coaches. He seemed pretty pent up about something. Since he was taking his anger out on Edward, we didn't know what was going on in his mind at the time, but Joseph told me they left half of their train at the platform instead of getting them all aboard before the blast hit them. But by the way he was acting, James definitely saw something the rest of us didn't. After laying about in the station for about an hour, before it was time we left, Felix and I were talking about how scary it was to run away from such a disaster. We've all decided to entirely the idea of going to Tidmouth and head straight to the Vicarstown Bridge. While we were heading down the line, Edward had to stop for water, made sure James didn't slow down, and shot right past us, hoping to get across to the mainland. However, they went on the wrong line and went straight to Sudbury. I haven't seen them since.